essentially, which is where we are today, this covers the bank. All I could mention is so that this one's temperature, so it's about every 125,000 years we get a warm period, which is a little spiky graph. Then it goes cold, and then we get another cold period. The CO2, which is the one at the top, that's the shadow of it. And in fact, it's the CO2 that drives the planet. Then we come, this is an expanding period. The vertical part of the graph is the same scale, but this covers the period. 1,500, and this red bit is since about 1860, which is when we started getting thermometers. So the appearance when the sun heat goes into the sea, and it's soaked up there, and it takes some time to light. Okay, so when we're planning about where the temperature is going to be and what's going to happen, there are some areas of uncertainty that are so complicated that people can't really, that the scientists can't faithfully predict what can happen. One of the big areas has been the atmosphere, where the effects of clouds, because the sun heat comes in, it's a lot of clouds there today, so that gets us cool. But on the other hand, it also radiates up from the surface of the earth, it's cloud, and gets it back again. So it's quite a complicated system, so there's a lot of uncertainty there. There is the seas, where the biggest problem with the sea is that we really have not very many airports. They've got the Argo project, where they've built the always right in the ocean, but that only got completed in 2004. So we've got 10 years worth of records, and they only go down at 2,000 meters. So the deep ocean is hardly the core of the core, but the big area of uncertainty there to the lack of records. The uncertainty there, and the uncertainty is catastrophic collapse. They can predict how quickly a block of ice will melt, but where it's huge, it will break off, and the glaciers will all start moving quickly. That's a little bit more difficult to predict. This area here is methane. There's an amount of methane stored in the tundra, and as that starts to melt, the fibrous matter, wood and grass will start to decompose, and the huge quantity of methane will come there. But how quickly it will come out and when it might start to come out is something uncertain. There are two other uncertainties. One is the CO2 that adhering to what's supposed to happen. Okay, Georgina Griffiths is another scientist, and she has done some research into the direction in New Zealand, what's happening the westerly winds that come around the country up against Scotland, and it's changing our climate. And so, this is the situation that we are in now, and it will make change. Dr. Orbit's about everything, research in government here. But this, it's certainly about a 10% increase in westerly winds, and you can see how the graph that I got there with other part of the research, we've got an increase in westerly winds, also in South Scotland. But so that's the increase in westerly winds that we're already having from climate change. And here's a bit of a few more. These are good. This has been consecutive rain, dry days. The black dots are the increases. So that on the east coast, we're getting more dry days. And the squares are the decreases. And the east coast, sorry, the west coast, is getting fewer dry days. So the west wind is coming in. And consistently gives us the dry day. And this is the other side of the coin. The number of wet days, and you can see the west coast is getting wetter, and the leaves are getting drier. So we'll be getting droughts. That's part of the reason, not the whole reason, but it is part of it. And I told you one of my story, this is better. This is the name of the little. Right, this is sea level rise, and this is taken from the Australian Sea Level Organization. And what they show is that this puts up over the whole period of the Earth for 25,000 years. So we're here, that's the last one. At the last warm period, the sea level is 6 meters higher. And the CO2 level at that time was only 300 parts per on the city, the other side. Yeah, that's not the old part of the business. So we are still becoming more acidic, and the big problem there is that these guys, this is the plankton. Their bodies, their structure, are in a calcium carbonate, and they dissolve in acidic water, and they are in a structure for the level of acidity that there is in the ocean. To make it is where I might be drifting away a little bit, but I've got a picture of a tree here, but the trees that we have today have taken millions of years to develop their structures. The last time we had 400 parts per million CO2 in the atmosphere was 4 million. So these trees have developed in a way that that is much more suited to the top level of 280 parts per million, and they are not equipped to deal with a new climate that's going to go with 400 parts per million. And as the climate comes up to match the 400, I think the trees are going to have a real tough time. And it's not just the trees, obviously. It's all the growth. Okay. Just to point out that what is happening in the rest of the world, this is the American Environmental Protection Agency's forecast for America in 2019. That's Holland. This is Sometimes looking at a picture makes it easier to absorb the information.